Welcome to the Civil War Digital Digest. I'm your host, Jeremy, and today we're going to show you another way to cook with a raw flour ration. Now, what we're using today comes from the book, A Drummer Boy's Diary, written by Bircher of the 2nd Minnesota. And before we get started here, let's hear what he has to say.
These were made by moistening our flour on a rock with water, and after pounding it into a tough dough, it was spun into a long roll about an inch in diameter, and wound spirally around a ramrod, and so baked at the campfire.
All right, pretty simple. We got the raw flour here in a mess pan. Now, we got some wind today, and I have this available, so we're gonna start the mixture here, so as we don't lose some of our flour in the wind. And instead of a large stone, we're using some scrap lumber. Now, the one thing to keep in mind is he did say he wanted a tough dough. Now, that means we want to start sparingly with the water, because we can always add more water in case it's a little thin. But you can't take water out and you might not have any more flour. So I'm first going to get this mixed up into a bit of a dough before I start kneading it. Need a little bit more water. All right, we're just about there where we're getting a nice ball formed up. And sometimes it's just easier to get in there with your hands. It's a little sticky at first. But like I said, we wanted a tough dough. So again, I'd rather work that raw flour in there and get rid of the stickiness than add too much water. Really what we're making here is essentially a hardtack. It's just wound around a ramrod, done in the field instead of large commercial ovens at some place like Bent's. Now if you have a little bit of salt, you could add salt to the flour and get a little bit of flavor, but we didn't have that available to us today. All right, we got that as a nice tough dough. And then Bircher explains to roll it out into an inch thick snake. Now, depending on your cooking surface, when you do this, you might want to reserve a little bit of flour so it doesn't stick to your surface. But it seems like I'm having pretty good luck with this board. All right, I think we're just about an inch there. And we're gonna get this wound around our ramrod, our cooking utensil. Bircher doesn't really give us too many instructions, but I found winding it tighter is gonna hold it on there a little bit better. And you might have to pinch those ends in order to keep it on. All right. Now, the next thing, of course, we got to put it over the fire, much like we did in the beefsteak episode. Just gonna get it right over those coals and use a log. To hold everything in position. Now you're gonna wanna keep an eye on it again, get it nice and golden brown. But while this is cooking, we're gonna clean up our board here and we'll be back in a few moments. All right, so it's been about 30 minutes and we think our dough god is all ready to eat. As you can see, as I pull it off the fire, you wanna make sure you keep an eye on it. Got a little burned on one side, the flames jumped up on us. But much like a camp setting and being on campaign, we wanted to get this cooked as fast as possible and consume it before we lay down to get some rest. So we're gonna get this cut off here. And you can see on the inside, it's nice and cooked through. And it's actually kind of crispy and soft on the inside, like a nice bread. I think this is going to turn out much nicer than you might anticipate. couple of tips again, keep an eye on the fire. It'll burn quick. It'll take about 30 minutes, but it depends on the thickness of the dough and, of course, your fire. And another final tip is once you're done with whatever containers, utensils that you're using to mix that dough, clean it up quickly because that flour and water is going to turn to concrete on you and be real difficult to get off. Hope you enjoyed this episode of the Civil War Digital Digest. If you did, hit the like button. Feel free to share it out with your friends and subscribe to the channel for updates.